Yes, no, maybe. Yes. Woo! Thank you, Jason. That's awesome. All right. You guys ready to go into some worship? Awesome, awesome. So I just want to read one scripture from Romans 8. Verse number 15 says, "This resurrection life you receive from God is not a timid, grave-tending life. It's adventurously expectant, greeting God with a childlike, 'What's next, Papa?' God's Spirit touches our spirits and confirms who we really are. We know who He is, and we know who we are. Father and children, and we know we are going to get what's coming to us, an unbelievable inheritance." All right.
Yes, Lord. We bless you, God. We thank you for just getting to get together, to be together with you, celebrating your house. Lord, we rejoice in who you are. We rest in the fact that, Lord, we can trust you. There's beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain. This freedom, though you've captured me, I've got joy instead of mourning. There's beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain. This freedom, though you captured me, I've got joy instead of mourning. You give me joy down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul. You give me joy down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul.
Been so secure, knowing your heart, Lord.
haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. You haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. No, you haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. Joy forevermore. Oh, you haven't known me. You haven't known me till you've known me filled with joy. You haven't known me till you've known me filled with joy. You haven't known me till you've known me filled with joy. Joy forevermore. Oh, you haven't seen me. You haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. You haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. Oh, you haven't seen me till you've seen me filled with joy. Joy forevermore. Oh, you haven't known me. You haven't known me till you know me filled with joy. Oh, you haven't known me till you know me filled with joy. You haven't known me till you know me filled with joy. Joy forevermore.
Thank you.
rise. Darkness tremble in your holy light. Every eye will see Jesus our God, great and mighty to be praised. Let hope arise and darkness tremble in your holy light. That every eye will see Jesus our God, great and mighty to be praised. Let hope arise, let hope arise, and darkness tremble in your holy light. Every eye will see Jesus our God, great and mighty. arise, and darkness tremble in your holy light. Every eye will see Jesus our God, great and mighty to be praised. With everything, with everything, with everything, with everything, all that is within me, praise His holy name. Let all that is within me, praise His holy name. Let all that is within me give you the highest praise. Yeah, let all that is within me praise His holy name. Let all that is within me praise His holy name. Let all that is within me
on, just begin to lift your voices. Come on. Come on, everyone in here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, release your sound tonight. Come on, release your worship. Come on, we're creating a throne tonight. Come on.
Jesus, we lift you high. Jesus, we lift you high. Lord of everything, He's creator, He is Savior, Lord of all, King of all, we raise you high, draw men to yourself as we lift you high. Lift you high, Jesus. Our God reigns. Our God reigns.
Come on, just lift up your voice tonight. All over the house, just give Him praise. The King of glory. We exalt you, God. You are worthy to be praised. You're worthy of honor. You're worthy of glory. You're worthy of might. You're worthy of dominion, God. There is no king like King Jesus. There is no one like our God. There's no God like Jehovah. There is no God like Jehovah. He is high and exalted above all. I want to declare this word over us tonight. I kept hearing it all throughout worship as a declaration over this people. Isaiah 61. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, to proclaim liberty to the captives, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to those who are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to console those who mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they may be called the trees of righteousness. It's what he wants to do here tonight. I came to declare it by the power of the Holy Spirit. There's freedom to be had in this place tonight. Whatever you need, I just feel the Lion of Judah roaring right now against every obstacle that you've had, every obstacle, every stronghold, every mountain that has positioned itself in front of you. The Spirit, the roar of God is coming and it's leveling out every obstacle. Come on, if you need freedom in your life tonight, why don't you lift up your hands? Jesus, Jesus, God, I declare freedom from the oppressed, Lord. I declare, Lord, freedom for those that are bound up tonight, God. We release the power of the love of the Almighty God. We release the power of His love, that the Lamb of God, that we receive the reward of His suffering in this place tonight. We declare it, freedom, 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 freedom. Tonight. Thank you, Jesus. See your sons and daughters here tonight. Holy Ghost, come and do what you want to do. Shamra masete rabakaye rosso hey namasatai hey 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 hey. Come on, one more shout tonight, one more shout tonight, give them all you have. About Mama G getting up here to speak. I'm having to fight against rushing just to get her up here, but there's a fresh move of God in this place tonight. And as much as I don't want to take any moments, the Holy Spirit is nudging me so strong I can't get away from it. If you need a fresh touch of the Holy Spirit tonight, why don't you come forward? If you need your fire rekindled tonight, come on. There is freedom. Come on. So much freedom. Come on, be bold tonight. He wants to breathe on the flames of your heart. He wants to rekindle the passion. Jesus, come on, if that's you tonight, doesn't matter how young, doesn't matter how old, He wants to return us tonight to our first love, the love of Jesus. Come on, church, stretch your hands forth to these that have come forward. God, we declare it tonight. Fresh fire. Fresh fire, Lord. Fresh fire, Lord. Fresh fire, God, right now, Lord. Rekindle, Lord. Kindle a fire. Jesus, Jesus, Lord. From her head to her feet right now, God. Burn, Lord. Jesus, fresh fire, Lord. Fresh fire. Fresh fire. Shokalabasatai. Helamashakalabasete. Horamasata. Fresh, 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 fresh. Renewal, God. Shalamasite Rabakai.
Showers of mercy and grace.
Kindle it, Lord. Horamakai. Fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire. Shalabasike. More, God, more, Lord, more. Pour out your wine, pour out your oil, God. Shalabakite. Fresh, Lord. Pour out the oil of heaven right now, God. Fresh outpouring of your spirit, Lord Jesus, now. In Jesus' name, 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 in Jesus' name. Horamasite rabakaye, horamashalabasete rabakaya. Freedom, Lord, freedom. Outpouring, Lord, right now, God. We anoint my sweet sister, Lord Jesus. Have your way. Jesus, fire. Fire and freedom. Fresh, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire right now, God.
Jesus reigns in this place. Showers of mercy,
fire of heaven, God. Consume, Lord, from head to feet right now. Consume, Lord, right now, from head to feet, God. Fresh, fresh, fresh fire, Lord. Come on, burn, Lord. We release the fullness, the fullness, the fullness of heaven right now. Lord, we ask for the electricity of heaven, Lord, right now to come, Lord. Permeate, Lord, every cell, every cell, every organ right now, Lord, in Jesus' name. Fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh anointing right now, Lord. Oil of heaven. Jesus. Fresh, Lord. Fresh, Lord. Fire, 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 Lord. Jesus. Lord, I pray, Lord, right now, oil of heaven pour out. Shakai, oil of heaven, Lord, pour out right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, fire of heaven come, Lord. Fire of heaven come, Lord. Horamasatai, joy, Lord. Joy, 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 God. Release the joy tonight. Release an impartation of joy tonight, God, Lord. Horamasatai. Holamakite shekera masatai. Lord Jesus, Father, I thank you, God, right now, Lord. Do a work right now in my sister, God. Awaken hearts tonight in this place. Awaken hearts abroad, Lord, right now. Jesus, Jesus, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, God. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Fresh fire, Lord. Come on, pour out, Lord, anew. Jesus, Lord, we release the oil of heaven right now, God. Lord, I declare refreshing right now, Lord, to the weary heart, God, that you're coming in a new way, that you're blowing a new wind, God, that you're stoking the fire of our heart, Lord. God, that you're blowing on those embers, Lord, that we would burn bright, that we would burn hot. God, that we would burn, Lord, that all the world would come to the brightness of your rising upon us, God, right now. Jesus, burn, burn, fire of heaven. Right now, God, burn, Jesus, burn, Lord, burn, rekindle, God, shalabaka, renew, Lord. Hola masatai, Jesus, thank you, Father God. Lord, we thank you for what you're doing in our children, God, right now, Lord. God, that you haven't reserved, Lord, but that you poured out fully, God, what you want to do through your Holy Spirit in these kids, God. We anoint and release in Jesus' name, fresh fire. Fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire, God. Burn in our homes. Burn in our homes, God. Burn in our homes, Lord. Ignite, 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 Lord Jesus. Shoramasite. Oramakata. Shoramasite. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Lord, I thank you for what you're doing in families now, God. Lord, I just say burn, 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 burn bright, Lord. Shalabakatai, poramasite, poramashaka. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Shokoyarabakai, polamasha. Fresh outpouring tonight. Fresh outpouring tonight. Fresh outpouring tonight. Poramasite rabakatarabashakaya. Ora masite la bakata, shala masite la bakunda. Yes, more God, more Lord, more Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. And I declare fiery passion returning in our marriages in this church. Even as we align ourselves with Him, I declare that every husband, every wife in this place, God, that you would take us back, Lord, that we would have a Holy Ghost honeymoon. Come on. Do you want that tonight? Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. God, we're so grateful to what you're doing here. And I just declare it to you, if you're watching tonight, we've got 109 different nations watching. If that's you tonight, just invite the presence of God into your home. I believe he's coming in a new way. I believe he's coming in a special way tonight. And I just declare it, every home set on fire with power, with power, with power in Jesus' name. Come on, give him a shout of praise tonight. Telling you, if we could just see ourselves the way he sees us. I was up here during altar time on Sunday, and I was seeing people come forward and get baptized, and man, I can't hardly even talk about it without being moved in my spirit, but I just say, God, I'm so thankful, Lord. I'm so thankful for what you're doing in this church, Lord, and what you're doing in our city, God. We have waited our lives for this moment. We've waited our whole lives, God, and I just thank you, Lord. The people that you've sent here to be a part of what you're doing, God, I'm eternally grateful, Lord. And I just believe you're going to do awesome. You've already done it. You're going to continue to do, even in this place tonight, awesome things. And so, God, I just say, blow our minds tonight. That's my prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Look, we got a lot of new faces tonight. I know it breaks the flow a little bit, but why don't you get back up and go hug somebody and tell them, hey, I'm glad you're here.
Hey, I want to ask Josh French to come on up here. Josh had felt something during worship, and I just wanted him to release this as well over you guys. And so come on, Josh. Let's welcome Josh French.
When the people came up here and Jeff asked for people to come up with that needed a fresh touch from the Holy Spirit, I felt this thing well up in me. And this is what it was. There is a place where you can get so dry and so, I have this pen. It's like an inkwell pen that you dip it and you write in it. And when you dip it and you write, and if you write enough, eventually the ink's going to run out and you have to dip it again. And if you don't dip that pen again, then it's just going to get dry and it's just going to start scratching the page. And nothing you write is going to come through. It's just going to be indentions and it can be, you know, just missed. And so what I felt the Lord saying was that I was supposed to pray for those that were here and really anybody that wants it, just a fresh outpouring of worship in your personal life. And in a place that you thought was dry, in a place that you thought was just, you know, scratching and tearing, but that worship would be there, that in the secret place and in the home and especially with husbands and wives together, worshiping together in the secret place. And I wanted to pray that over you guys because I felt it so strongly and I felt like it was so important to release to you guys a fresh fire of worship. A fresh fire of intimacy in the Father. A fresh fire of knowing Holy Spirit. Of knowing who He is. And Father, I thank You that You've given it to these already. That You've revealed Yourself to them. That they worship You, Father. That they praise You, Lord. I pray for a fresh fire. A fresh fire that wells up from within them, that starts in their feet, Lord, in the foundation, and just burns up through their entire body, God. That it burns up. And I pray that You would bring it, Lord, in the places where they felt dry, in the places where they felt abandoned, that worship, God, that spirit. And I pray that You would build their faith in that, God. And so I want to encourage you. I want to encourage you in those places that you feel dry to worship. To worship. It doesn't always have to be a song or a dance, but it can be. And it doesn't always have to be a something that you might expect is artistic. Worship is any earnest reaction. to knowing and discovering something that's true about God. And he loves you. And he loves you. So burn in that and practice it in the secret place, at home, alone, with your family, especially with your wife and with your husband and with your children. And so thank you. Thank you for letting me say that.
Come on. You know, honestly, it's biblical, you know, in Exodus, okay, the reason why they had the Exodus of Egypt and the Lord brought them out with the gold and the silver was because they were supposed to create a place of worship in their wilderness. Because if you can't worship in your wilderness, you'll never be able to occupy your promise. Amen? So how many of you have felt like you've been in that place that Josh was talking about? Father, right now, we thank you that you're creating new places of worship in the midst of what we have perceived as wilderness. And so, Father, right now, how many of you feel the presence of the Lord right there? In fact, if you feel the presence of the Lord in your skin right now, just begin to stand up right now. I believe that joy is going to begin to come to your heart. I just felt electricity begin to start moving upon my hands and my feet right now. And so, Father, right now, God, we bless, Lord, what you're releasing in this room right now. Father, we bless, Lord, the spirit of truth. God, we bless, Lord, worship in the wilderness that we might occupy the place called promise. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Father, I thank you, Lord, in the places that we thought we were dry, you were about to make us wet. God, you said in Psalm 107 that you would make wilderness to become a pool and dry grounds to begin to spring forth. For one reason, there you make the hungry dwell. And so, God, I thank you, Lord, that in the midst of those seasons, you've created a grace of hunger in our life whereby we could dig fresh pools of outpouring and springs of refreshing. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, welcome. We're so glad that you're here tonight at Kingsway Church. And we've got some great friends here with us tonight. We've got our folks from Seven Springs. Come on, let's thank you. If you're here from Seven Springs, go ahead and stand up. We want to welcome you guys, Daniel and Colony and several of the crew. They just brought a handful of folks tonight, but we love these guys so much. They're family to us, so they're family to you. And let me also, if you're here for the very first time, raise your hand. Because we've got a gift we want to give you. If you're here for the first time, just raise your hand wherever you are. The ushers are going to make their way around to you. And just keep it up until they get that card to you. And they're going to be handing you a card. It's called a Connect card. And Clayton, if you hear that, you hear that echoing happening, we need to fix that. They're going to hand you a Connect card. If you can fill that out and put it in the offering basket, what we're going to do is we're going to send you an email with a free digital download link to some of our Kingsway worship. And also, one of the things on there is I want to call each and every one of you. This is one of the things that I love to do is to call those who are visiting with us so that I can pray with you specifically for the areas you're believing for breakthrough. So be sure you put your area that you're believing God to begin to move in your life, and then also any information about your family so that we can best minister to them as well. So speaking of family, let's have the kids come on up. Come on, King's kids, 12 and under. If you're here and you're 12 and under, come on down. Come on, come on. And where's Miss Amy? Come on, Miss Amy.
Hallelujah. Shikere Baba.
Come on up here. Tell us what we're going to be doing tonight, Amy. Come on. Yep. Y'all let Miss Amy through.
Ooh, that was good worship.
Yeah,
it was right? Good prep because we're going to be talking about worship tonight. Wow, I feel the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Man. We did Spies in July, where we investigated worship all month. We did some fun stuff. And today I was like, well, Lord, it's the last Wednesday in July. What should we do? Review, wrap it up, do some fun stuff, you know? And then he just kept putting things under the door. Tell him this, tell him that. And I was like, that's a lot for a night, God. And he's like, yeah, it is. And he starts laughing with me. And he's like, it's time. We're going deeper. We're going to keep it going. Because worship is the key. It is so key. And when we see his beauty, we have to respond because he made us for worship. He made us in his image. He made us for his pleasure. And so when we see him clearly, it's a natural thing to worship. He doesn't need our worship, but he says, praise me because of what it does for us. And it is key. And every single child here has a combination code to his heart nobody else has. Every single one has a key. And the Lord told me, it's with my own children. And he reminded me, whew, today, you just bring them to the gate. Just bring them to the gate, show them their key. I'll take it from there. Come on. And he's going to take it from there. And tonight, we're going to go deep. Come on. We're going to one of my favorite places in worship. And it's pure, and it's beautiful. And you feel his love, and it changes everything. Yeah. So, Lord.
Jesus. Yeah.
We are your children, God.
Come on.
And you are the good Father.
Yes.
And when we see you clearly, we see who we are. And we worship you, God. You're beautiful, God. You are beautiful. We just declare your beauty in this place over every single heart. Let it transform and go deep all through our week that worship is who we are because we were made for your pleasure. And it's where we receive your love and the key to go deeper. Thank you for opening up doors tonight. Thank you for what's happening in here. And thank you that you just knit our hearts together in unity. Because there is something powerful that happens when we all worship together. I thank you that in each heart, Jesus is arising, and he is going to stand up. And when he stands up, we will stand with him. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Come on. And when you said that about worship is the key, I heard to your fertility. And I feel like that worship, for those of you who have experienced a season of barrenness, whether it be spiritually or even naturally, I feel like worship is the key to your fertility, to causing the ground of your life to become fertile again. Amen? So you guys have an amazing time with Miss Amy tonight. Come on, let's thank the Lord for all of our King's kids. I got to find the chicken emoji. Hey, and also, I think we've got some new kids with us today, so let's make sure they get Honey Word Bibles too. And Tina, let's have Tina come on up and tell us what the women are going to be doing this Friday. Come on, let's thank the Lord for Pastor Tina. Come on.
Thank you, and child. Well, we're kind of having a lot of fun this summer. We've been having fun with this study, but it's been real spirit-led. We walk through the Keep Your Love On book, which you've heard me say 100 times. Please get your hands on it. It's amazing. It's by Danny Silk, and it's good for all relationships, parents, children, closest friends, and certainly your spouse. It talks about, it gives real keys. We talked about keys. In worship, the Lord showed me that... Well, about 2 weeks ago when I was asking where we're going to go with the Keep Your Love On, he kept giving me the verse to, on all occasions, pray in the Spirit. And we've been really going Spirit in these meetings the last few weeks. We're connecting with the heart of the Father and saying, you know, we want you to be our number one. And then these keys that we're giving for relationships, they're like the sprinkles on top of our cake from the Lord. That's what I've always felt like. So we have to go to him first. And in our groups, we're spending time encouraging each other, talking to one another, praying together, and saying, hey, how's it going? You know, we have the knowledge. Are we able to walk this thing called love out? And so it's really, really, really good. And so we've had Suzanne Watley get up, Amy Sky has been getting up, and just different women and lots of testimonies. And so it's a great time to get together, to encourage one another, and to keep growing in this thing called love.
How many of you want to grow in your love? Come on, we all do. So I want to invite you ladies out this Friday, 10 to 12. And hey, let's have Ben come on down. Come on, Ben. I want to hear from your heart. What are we going to be doing tonight upstairs? Come on. How many of you love what God is doing in and through our youth? Ain't it been amazing?
Oh, yeah. So the worship night went so It was so awesome. The presence was just, it came right down. And we were kind of scared because our rehearsal went really well. And usually that means the set doesn't go so well. But it was a good rehearsal and a great set. And so the turnout was great. The spirit was so thick. And we're super excited to do it again. So that was awesome. And so tonight we're going to kind of follow up with last week. We were kind of talking about identity and teaching between the difference in being a servant and a son. So we're super excited about that.
And listen, I'm telling you, God is about to invade this place with young people. How many of you believe that? And so we just want to tell you guys, Ben, Ashton, and every one of you, we are so proud of you. We are so proud of what God is doing in you. And we are so proud and expectant for what God is about to do through you. Amen? We love you, man. Y'all have fun tonight. Come on, youth, you can go ahead and head out the back and head up the upper room. And also, the ushers are going to come around. We want to tell you about an upcoming event called Unity in the Community. Say, Unity in the Community. And so Dee and the guys have these flyers in the back, and we're going to go ahead and just hand these out to where everybody can get one of these. We also ask if you'd like to get more of these flyers and hand them out specifically in the community, going door to door or going to businesses and dropping these off. Let me tell you what this is. I got a call on Monday that the mayor wanted to meet on Tuesday. Okay, and I was like, okay. And here was what it was. They wanted to say, okay, listen, they had heard about some of what we had done here with our pastors and leaders conference and our gathering where we had that restoration and reconciliation forum with Lieutenant and Chief of Police of Irondale and so many folks who were there and just really got to ask questions and how can we really not just how many of you know there's some stuff going on in the world, amen? And I've talked a lot about this in the past. Everybody knows where I stand. I don't want to get my preach on right now. But there's questions that need to be asked so that answers can be heard, so that people can begin to walk in unity within the community. Amen? Because let me tell you this. Fear is bad. Amen? Fear is bad. And we've talked about the root of racism. Jesus said, listen, this is he said, there's no greater commandment than this, to love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and then what? To love your neighbor as yourself. And see, the thing that racism reveals is self-hatred. And see, what happens is you have that, and then you have other people who then get on the other side of it. You got racism, you have rebellion, but how many of you know righteousness is the answer, amen? And so we're here as the body of Christ to lead the city in righteousness, to see not just the churches working together, but all of the community coming together as well, amen? And so myself and Pastor Mike McClure from Revelation Ministries, we're going to be MC in this event. And we have FBI agents that are going to be coming. We have several chiefs of police. We have the U.S. attorney that's going to be there. We have several sheriffs that are going to be there, defense attorneys, all that kind of stuff. And we're going to be fielding questions from the community. And Mike and I will, in terms of anybody who comes, we're going to serve a full barbecue dinner about 4:00. This is going to be, by the way, we're blocking off all of 2nd Avenue. The mayor's blocking the whole thing off. Myself and Pastor Mike McClure are going to speak before city council about this on Tuesday and about how the community and the city and the church can begin to start working together. Amen. How many of you believe we got to see that happen? And so all of the information is on here, and it's going to be a regular thing. We're doing the next one here, and it's going to be awesome. So the details for the cookout's at 4, and we're getting a big tent so we can do it out in the street, and it's going to be awesome. And so mark your calendar to be there, but also try to bring members of the community with you as well, and it'll be a great time. Also, I want to let you know, I know a bunch of our folks tonight are over at the visitation for Jonathan and Jennifer Granberry and for the family there. And want to let you know, tomorrow at 10:00 at Church of the Reconciler is going to be Jonathan's Celebration of Life service. And I know that with work, some people can't get there, and that's why some people went tonight. But we'll all be going over there. I encourage you to get there early because it will be packed, okay? And so, again, if it's in your heart to go and you want to go and support the Granberry family, it'll be at 10:00 tomorrow. And it's interesting. How many of you know that God knows what he's doing? Amen? And it was interesting this past week, even as I was praying Saturday night about how we needed to position ourselves Sunday morning, knowing that we had lost someone to cancer that we cared very deeply for, amen? Listen, he was a part of our family, wasn't he? And how many of you know that hurts to lose? And I see so often when people lose someone they love, they back up. And what I loved about our church and I loved about our family, and Clayton, if you can help me on this, I loved about our family is that we didn't back up, but we went forward, amen? And what happened? God began to start healing people. Not only did testimonies of cancer healing, COPD healing, and other healings come, but all of a sudden, both services broke out in healing explosions. Because, see, listen, you're not called to give ground back to the enemy. Amen? And just like we've talked about the last 2 weeks, is we've got to be a mature people that can rightly respond to disappointment, that we don't allow the groanings of creation to ruin our reputation as sons of God, but that we can stand strong in truth, that we can weep with those who weep, we can rejoice with those who rejoice. But like David, he wept and he fasted while his son was sick. And then once his son passed, he dusted himself off and he said, there must be a battle to fight. And I'm telling you, there's a battle to be fought that has already been won, and it's against cancer, and it's against the strongholds and the principalities that have come against this city for so long. And that's why God showed up in such power on Sunday morning to encourage everyone's heart that, listen, we've already won this thing. We're not called to back up. We're called to move forward. Amen? Does this make sense? And it's important. It's important to be able to pastor a congregation's heart, a people's heart, to where we do not lose heart. Because how many of you know in Galatians 6, it says we will reap if we do not lose heart. Amen? It's a season called due season. And I believe we're in that due season. It's a season of birthing. And I remember watching an interview one time with Bill Johnson, and they were asking him, they said, listen, how did Bethel become what Bethel is? And in terms of this place of revival, this place of healing, this place of miracles, he said, I'll tell you what happened. For 18 months, now listen, don't hear what I'm not saying, okay? I'm not saying we ain't going through no 18-month cycle. I'm just saying that right now, okay? I'm saying this to encourage your hearts, okay? He said, for 18 months, we saw people that we loved dearly be lost to diseases that we see healed every day. You know, how do we see someone testify 1 week of being healed of stage 4 leukemia? We lose another brother the next Saturday, and then on Sunday morning, we have people beginning to testify of cancer again. God does not need our excuses. It's not up to us to provide reasons why God does or why God doesn't. It's our responsibility to pray and to believe God to do what he does. And so Bill Johnson said, we had opportunity with every moment of loss to change our doctrine that God is only and always good. He said, and every time we experienced loss, we had to recognize that God was only good. No matter what happened in our life, we were not going to change our stance. No matter what happened in our life, we're not going to change our belief. No matter what happened in our life, we were not going to give up, but we were going to move forward. And I'm telling you, with every time, I am more resolved right now for this to be a cancer-free zone than I ever was. And I'm telling you, I am more resolved to go after healing, to go after wholeness, to go after the working of miracles. It felt good just to jump around in the anointing again on Sunday, didn't it? It felt good just to not play church and just go after some raw faith in the kingdom and begin to see what God wanted to do and only God could do, amen? And I'm telling you, we're about to come into the days of raw faith and great authority and increase of anointing. But I'm telling you, it's not going to come to the complacent, to the apathetic, or to those who wait for the kingdom to come. The kingdom of God is within you, and the kingdom of God wants out. And I'm telling you, God is about to raise up fiery hot witnesses of his power, fiery hot witnesses of his heart, that would not just talk about the things of God, but they would demonstrate the things of God. Paul said, listen, the gospel I bring to you is not according to the wisdom of man. It's not in the eloquence of speech, but it's in a demonstration of power. And I'm telling you, Birmingham, Alabama is looking for a demonstration of power. They're not just looking for people who can talk about God. They're looking for people who can reveal their God, who can step up and say, cancer, go right now. And then name of Jesus. Dead be raised in the name of Jesus. Blind eye be open. Deaf ear begin to hear. Because now is the time. The harvest is ripe. And I want you to know, listen, the gifts of the Spirit are not some carnival trick to make you look good in the moment. They are harvest tools to go out and reap the fields that are already ripe, so where we can see a whole generation come into their father's house and experience the spirit of adoption that all of creation is groaning for. Everything that's happening in the world right now is simply the groanings of creation desiring the sons of God to be made manifest. And I'm telling you, we owe the world an encounter. We owe Alabama an encounter. We owe Birmingham an encounter. But you can't give what you don't got. And that's why worship is so important. Because when we allow our heart to come out of worry and we allow it to come into a place of worship, we become an open door whereby the King of Glory can come in. And so, Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, God, we celebrate life that has been lived.
Father, we weep with those who weep, but we rejoice with those who rejoice. And Father, we declare in the name of Jesus that these are the days of greatest harvest. These are the days of greatest miracles. That, Lord, we're not looking back at what was, but we're looking forward at what will be in the name of Jesus. And I thank you that you're looking for a people that you can mark with your spirit and anoint with your power to begin to walk out in your authority to where cancer would have to go, to where viruses would have to leave, to where demonic influences and presence would have to go in Jesus' name. And so, Lord, we draw. We and, you know, it's already here, but we recognize, Lord, the atmosphere and the anointing that's on this property. To where when people come on and tormenting voices have to leave. When people come on the property and sickness has to leave their body. But Lord, I believe that even when the mayor and the chief of police start calling and saying, listen, what you're doing there, we want it to begin to stretch into the city. God, that you're stretching out our tent stakes. That it's not just about Kingsway Church. It's not just about a geographical window. But Lord, that you're giving us the city for your glory. God, you're giving us keys to the city. And worship is the key to begin to unlock the heart of this city. To where Birmingham, Alabama, Irondale, Alabama, and this entire region, right now, the whole Birmingham metro area, right now, Alabama will be ablaze with the glory of God. And I'm telling you, people say, if we can just get to Alabama, just like getting to Spokane, Washington, and the healing rooms of the past, or Zion, Illinois, in the days of John Alexander Dowie, if we could just get out of where we are and go into a place that has already tapped into the well of healing, we could begin to be healed and made whole in our body. And I'm telling you, listen, I'm not big on geographical portals and all that kind of stuff because I believe, listen, anywhere you are, God is, and he's wanting to move. But I also know that sometimes people can begin to reach a point of contending in their heart to where they tip the scales to where all of a sudden what God has placed in begins to come out. And that's what's happening here. I'm telling you, God is finding a people that he can possess with promise. He's finding a culture of hope that he can begin to move in and begin to move through in a way to where he and he alone is lifted up. In Jesus' name. And so, Lord, we thank you, Lord, for all of the miracles. We thank you for all of the healings we're seeing. We're thanking for all of the salvations we're seeing, all of the baptism. But God, I gotta be honest, the more you show us, the more we want. The more we see, the more we got to have it. God, in Jesus' name, amen. Man, Macho Man, spirit of Macho Man came on me there for a moment. Didn't that sound like Macho Man Randy Savage? Come on, Jesus. Typically, a spirit of Ric Flair will jump on me, but that Macho Man, that's a new one. Oh, what you gonna do when the Macho Man comes for you? Okay. Man, hallelujah. Hey, let's take an offering. How about that? Come on. Hey, turn in your Bible to 1 Chronicles chapter 29, and we're starting verse 10, and this is an amazing it's an amazing prayer. It's an amazing, it's called David's praise to God, but really it's more than that. It's a reflection. It's a prayer. It's a response to who God is and what God has asked David and his son to do. Because how many of you know God is a generational God? And so if you're making out checks tonight, you can make them out to Kingsway Church. If you want to make them out, if you want to get by cash or credit card, there are envelopes in the seat pocket in front of you. And just again, we're positioning ourselves right now as a ministry that takes a major steps of faith in preparation for the harvest. And so if the Lord is speaking to you tonight to take a step of faith of generosity, go for it. Because it is very needed right about now. Amen. We're just about to get this place just absolutely ready for the harvest. Because how many of you know when the harvest hits, you don't have time to make it ready. And there are things that need to be done so we are harvest ready. I'm telling you, and I'll give you an example. Listen, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to a whole lot of people to dig a hole in your stage and to break into the ground to put the biggest baptism you can find in all of Alabama. We had to get this thing custom made. But 552 people that have been water baptized since the beginning of the year could justify to that. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense for a church to build an extension to a building to house a 14 by 16 walk-in freezer, a 10 by 8 walk-in cooler. But I'm telling you, all of a sudden, when you look back and you realize that we've given away 338,000 pounds of food, all of a sudden you can begin to, well, this makes a whole lot more sense.
You know, and I'm telling you, and I can tell you, it's story after story and time after time to where it may not have made sense to your natural mind and where you were, but God said, listen, I'm looking for a faithful priest, one who will do according to what's in my mind and what's in my heart. And I'm telling you, God is not looking for one priest. He's looking for kings and priests. He's looking for all of us to say, God, whatever's in your heart, we want to say yes. Whatever's in your mind, we want to think the thoughts. We want to walk in the ways. We want to be the expression of Jesus here on the earth. Amen? And so David here, he's reflecting, and again, they're going to put it on the screen. 1 Chronicles chapter 29, verse 10. It says, David blessed the Lord before all the assembly. And David said, blessed are you, Lord God of Israel, our Father, forever and ever. Yours, O Lord, is the greatness, the power, and the glory, the victory and the majesty, for all that is in heaven and in earth is yours. Yours is the kingdom, O Lord, and you are exalted as head over all. Both riches and honor come from you. John said it like this. He said, man has nothing unless it's first given to him by God. Riches and honor come from you, and you reign over all. In your hand, oh man, I just want to tell you, God is reigning over America. And anybody saying anything else has become a mouthpiece for the devil. I'm just saying, oh man, America's greatest days are ahead of us. I'm telling you, oh man, I could tell you, but it's not my night to preach. We are about to come into the greatest days of harvest, the greatest days of awakening. And I'm telling you, we are about to become the lighthouse we were always meant to be. And we've seen moments of it. We've seen glimpses of it. And yes, as a nation, mistakes have been made. As a people, mistakes have been made. But we're about to see the heart of a nation turn to God in a day, in Jesus' name. And I'm telling you, we've never been more poised for revival and awakening than we are right now. In Isaiah 60, it says, you will shine the brightest when deep darkness is on the earth and deep darkness the people. Check. Stars shine the brightest when? At night. So listen, Daniel 12:3 says that we will shine like stars. It says those who are wise will shine like stars and instruct many in the ways of righteousness. So as what if the stars ran from the darkness? There would be no shining. Amen? And I'm telling you, listen, we're not called to run from the darkness. We're called to run to the darkness. And we're not called to run with a critical finger. We're called to run after darkness with our arms spread wide open and say, let me tell you what he did for me and what he's about to do for you. Listen, love is our light. Amen? Love is our light. But it goes on, he said, you reign over all. You reign over America. You reign over the nations of the earth. You reign over Alabama. You reign over Birmingham. You reign over Irondale. You reign over Kingsway Church. In your hand is power and might. And in your hand it is to make great and to give strength to all. Now, therefore, our God, we thank you. We thank you and praise your glorious name. But who am I and who are my people that we should be able to offer so willingly as this? For all things come from you, and of your own we have given you. And what David is saying here is, Lord, he saw giving as a privilege. He said, who are we to be able to give back to you, the one true God? Who are we to be able to partner with the living God in the building of his house, seeing the whole earth filled with the knowledge of his glory? Who are we? I want to tell you, listen, giving is not a requirement. Generosity is a privilege. Amen? God so loved that he gave, and giving and generosity models the heart of the Father more than just about anything. Isn't that right, Terry? There is something about generosity that begins to reveal the goodness of our Father like nothing else does. But then it goes on and says in verse 15, it says, for we are aliens and pilgrims before you, as were all our fathers. Our days on the earth are as a shadow and without hope. O Lord, our God, all this abundance that we have prepared to build you a house for your holy name is from your hand and is all from your own. Verse 17, I know also, my God, that you test the heart and have pleasure in uprightness. Anybody ever had God test your money? You know, that's where you get the testimony. Anybody ever had God test your money? He's like, I want that. Like, oh, no, God, you don't want that. How about this? You know, anybody ever try to bargain with God? Listen, there's intent behind what he asks you for. Because, listen, he's going to ask for a specific seed that's connected to a specific harvest. He doesn't just ask willy-nilly. He doesn't need anything from us, but he is wanting to do a work in our hearts to where he can get everything to us, to where he can get it through us. How many of you believe that? You test the heart and have pleasure in uprightness. As for me and the uprightness of my heart, I have willingly offered all these things. But then this is what I love, and now with joy. In other words, David said, listen, Lord, I've been there. I've been a man of worship. I've been a man of generosity. But now I have joy because I have seen your people who are present here to offer so willingly to you. Amen? And so I just believe that there is a level of joy that we can tap into as it relates to generosity. Hey, you know, God, it says that God loves a cheerful giver. Amen? Amen? And so let's do this tonight. Let's just ask the Lord what he would have us to do. Please, one thing we believe that pressure is bad. How many of you believe that? God delights in free will offerings. God delights in obedience. God delights in people saying, okay, what would you have me to do? And I will do that. But like I talked to you a couple weeks ago, I said, listen, you know, Caleb's job at my house is to take out the trash. And so often I had to say, hey, Caleb, come take out the trash. But I'm telling you, those days when he just gets up and takes out the trash without me asking, those are the days I'm like, he's getting it. How many times do we look to God to ask us to give before we give? And it's great to give in terms of obedience to what God asks, but there's a place of honor that we can move into to where we can give, knowing that we want to partner with what our Father is doing without even having to be asked in the moment. Amen? And so, Father, I just thank you, Lord, for generosity all across this room tonight. God, I thank you, Lord, that even as we sing this song tonight, God, we are prophesying to our city. We are prophesying to the heavens. We are prophesying to the earth. We are declaring and we are decreeing, God, and believing in what you have promised to do in this place. In Jesus' name. Everybody go ahead and stand to your feet tonight. Father, we thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. God, thank you, Lord, for radical generosity. Lord, thank you, God, Lord, for releasing generosity through us and generosity to us, Lord. Father, I thank you, Lord, for opening up brand new revenue streams in our life in Jesus' name. God, I thank you, Lord, that you're bringing promotions that we've longed and waited for. God, I thank you, Lord, that there's creative business ideas that are coming now. God, I thank you there are calls that we've been waiting on that all of a sudden our name and our number is showing up on that person's desk. God, I thank you, Lord, that you're beginning to move heaven and earth as it relates to finances. And I'm telling you, God says that he would open up the windows of heaven over your life to pour out a blessing that you can't contain, but we've got to align ourselves in the earth under that open window in the heavens. And so, Father, right now, whatever you would have us to do, God, we say yes in Jesus' name. Amen? Come on down and let's minister to the Lord in our giving tonight.
Oh, we join with you, Lord of the harvest. Send forth laborers to the field. We call.
Prophesy it right now.
Wash all the darkness.
Come on, let's stand up and decree this right now.
With the sound of your name. Come, let your glory remain all over this town. Send your rain. Wash all the darkness away.
Call on the Lord of the harvest. See, God commanded, he said, pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers. Come on, let's just...
call on you, Lord of the harvest.
Come on.
Send forth your laborers into the fields.
Come on, make it a prayer tonight.
We call on you, Lord of the harvest. Send forth your laborers into the fields. Oh, we call on you, Lord of the harvest. Send forth your laborers into the fields. Oh, we call on you, Lord of the harvest. Send forth laborers into the fields. Here am I. Here am I.
Father, here we are. Send us, God. Lord, we say yes to the harvest. God, we say yes to you, Lord. Father, we thank you, Lord, for what you've already done here tonight. Lord, everything that's already come forth with so many folks sharing. Father, and I thank you, Lord, for what you're going to bring forth now in Jesus' name. God, I thank you for Greta. I thank you for John. God, we ask, Lord, that your anointing would fall heavy upon them. And God, that the fullness of what you want to speak to through each of them would come forth tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Can y'all help me welcome Greta Ivy.
Have been so absolutely encouraging all week. It's been frightening. It really has, because I feel like I have an expectation. It's good to have an expectation, right? I'm just going to start with the, oh. I like that word. I like that. Hi, everybody. I'm Greta.
Hey. Greta!
I am Greta. I want to start by sharing about something. Jason, I don't remember the time frame, but for a lot of you guys, you remember not too long ago when we had the time where I came in the sanctuary and I had this thing that was going on in my heart where I went to the ground. I came in, and as soon as I entered into our building, I hadn't even made it to the sanctuary, I felt something in my heart. It just felt like I took a blow to the heart. So I went over to the nurse and mom's room and everything, and I was really just outdone for a minute trying to figure out what was going on. I was lightheaded. It was kind of frightening. So I laid on the floor for a minute. I felt like I had to just go down. I felt like I just needed to lay down. And Jason ended up coming in. They came and got Jason, and he came in, and he said I couldn't even pray for a minute, which is very unusual for me. I usually can war. I usually can push back anything. I just know a place in God where I know how to push certain things back. That particular day, though, I couldn't find my voice. I was in pain. I mean, like, it was different. So he came in and he sat with me, but he started praying in the spirit. And I was able to catch the wind of the spirit when he did that. And so it was taking me out into a place where while my body was still there and I was still feeling this pain, I was able to just ascend to a way where I knew I was going to get up. So I was telling Jason, I said, Jay, I want to stand up. I tried to stand up. It felt like I went down again. So I got up. I finally came in. I said, I think I can make it to the sanctuary. As soon as I got over here,
we came through these doors. As soon as I got over here, I knew immediately that it was spiritual. I knew nothing was going on physically in my body, and I felt like a fight. So that particular day, Jason had me come on the stage, and you know, we ended up praying and everything, but he asked me to do something. He asked me, he said, Greta, I believe you have authority to do something here in this place. I'm sensory. So all of my movement and everything is really how God moves through me, how I am comfortable flowing in the spirit, even though I don't understand a lot of times what's going on. But he told me, I did pray for a minute, but then there's a time where he said, you have the authority to do something in this place. And the only thing I felt was to go low. So I sat down, and I remember singing a song, but I didn't feel like I did what God wanted to do. I felt like the Lord wanted to do something else, and I didn't understand it because I didn't understand what authority did I have to be able to do something here. So I would, you know, have a conversation with the Lord about that. Like, Lord, I hear you saying this. I heard Jason say this. And it just, you know, it bothered me for a while. It was like there was some tension there. There was something else that needed to be done. And why isn't that I did not see that? And so last week when he called me out again, because this is not my thing. I wanted to stay down here and move and roar a little bit, get loud. he asked me to speak, I was like, Lord, really? He was like, what have I been speaking to you about, Greta? He's been speaking to me about a lot of things. I'm like, okay, you've been speaking to me about a lot of things. So I start having all of these images of different things, but the most significant one is authority. And so as we, over the course of the last few weeks, you know, we've been having teaching on identity and love, and last week was phenomenal to me because it seems like what was discussed last week, I had that same conversation. Like, I have these conversations, but they're able to make it into a preach. I'm like, when I grow up, I want to be able to do that. I can talk all day, but to preach, to put that thing into a word is like another thing. So the two people that spoke last week, Purcell, I don't know the young lady that spoke, Jana. So Jana was talking about love. Jana was speaking about love. And one of the first things I knew the Lord was doing to me was building this love thing. You know, most of you guys know that I'm married, been married 23 years. So I know what it is to just be able to stand in love, to believe God. One of the first things that the Lord spoke to me was that my husband and I were going to do something in ministry. So I've been able to live off that word. I've been able to love when I have felt lonely or all the things that you feel when you're married, and especially when you aren't walking together the way you think, you know that the Lord would have you to walk together. So all through this, it's like he would always say when I was discouraged or whatever, he says, the Lord would say, I love you. And I always say, Lord, I know you love me. And I'm learning even now that being able to stand in a battle when you're discouraged, when you feel like you want more, there's something to knowing and experience the love of God that will give you strength to do anything. The Lord gave me a promise. I've been able to live out of that promise because I know his love. He introduced himself to me as love. You know, he said, I know you and I love you. There's nothing you can tell me about anything, about what I do, that God does not love me. I know this. I move from this place. I live from this place. But I am still coming into it, learning more about it. So they were speaking about love. And then, she spoke about love. And then he was talking about being free in the spirit and everything, right? So that's my lane. I'm like, okay. And afterwards, JP, sometimes I call him JP, sometimes I call him Purcell, he calls me out, right? He's like, when he was praying for everybody, he said, God is getting ready to increase your responsibility. And I'm like, I have been having all of these little notes about that. And I'm like, okay, Lord, again, I'm cool. Can we just do this the way I want to do this? You know, I'm all right in this space. And so he is like, you know I love you, right? I'm like, without a doubt. He was like, okay, stop tripping. And I'm going to talk to you guys like the Lord talks to me, okay? So he was like, okay, so stop tripping. And when Jason came in and called me out, he wasn't even up here, so I couldn't jump on him. I couldn't punch him or anything. It's like, I'm looking for him. Like, are you serious? And he's in the back. You knew what you were doing. You knew what you were doing. So I am going to obey. And I've been really thinking about that day. I believe, you guys, I know one thing for sure, that the Lord said concerning that day, this is a people that have a heart, his heart, for the kingdom and the things that he's designed in this area. The experience that we've been going through over the last couple of years, actually, I'm going to say five, because the last 5 years have been, since like 2010, have been wowing. Like, lost my house, lost my cars, just everything that I worked for and felt like I was responsible to have and had done what I knew how to do, faithful, good steward, the whole nine, lost it all. Husband lost his job after being at a company for 20 years. So basically, we went from having a six-figure from him to me and what I used to call my play money, you know, just so I wouldn't have to ask him for money. So we had to live in that place. We had to live in a place of trust, for real. Like, for real trust. How are we going to eat? And the funny thing about it is, it was crazy, but couldn't get free lunch from our kids. I still made more money where we couldn't get help from anybody else. It had to come from the Lord. Everything that we had to come from the Lord. There is no way that you could see it. There is no way that you could plan it. I didn't have anything except, Lord, I trust you. I know your faithfulness. I know that you, who you are and who you have shown yourself to be for me. And my husband would have questions about, how did God do that? How was this possible? So you guys, for 2 years, we lived off our savings, off our 401k. My mortgage was $2,000. I might have had a couple dollars, but trust me, it was not like that. It just was not like that. We lived 2 years in our home, and when I tell you, all I could do was worship God. I worshiped. I was so thankful. Today, I am thankful. There is no way I would have ever stood before anybody dressed like this, because I like to dress. I like shoes. I like, you know, we're going to do this thing. We're walking this out. I had to learn how to humble myself, how to trust in the faithfulness of God, how to understand what it is to not try to be impressive. I believe that all of these things that we have gone through as a church, if we were to go down the aisle, there would be so many things that we learned that we used to think were important and that we had earned, and they are so insignificant. They are so insignificant. Just to hear the guys that have been ministering lately, you know, Matt used to lead pastor a church, JP pastored a church. You know, we get to these places where we feel like this is it and we're just going to go from this place. And again, you're doing what you know how to do. You feel like you're being obedient to God and that this is what he has from you. And then there's a time where there's a switch where it's really, do you know me? Do you love me? Do you trust me? Do you trust my love for you? And it's a beautiful place to be. when the Lord asked me, when I got down low about the authority thing, I have really just been having this tension with him, this thing. So he says, he needed to know that our hearts was right. And on that day, the enemy tried to attack our hearts. He knew it was like some kind of way it was understood that we were getting ready to go to a place. And the Lord, us, the ones that stood in that place, I feel like he said that we have pure hearts, that we can be trusted with what he has for us in this hour. And tonight, we were talking about power all through worship. It's about power. But I believe that the Lord is speaking to us right now about authority. We are people that move in power. He wants to give us authority. There is a difference. When we walk in power, power is great, but people don't always change when they have power. People can have an encounter with God and still trip. In the word, okay, Pastor, you're going to help me out again because I'm just being Greta. they worshiped. It was they worshiped when was it Moses when they were up when he came down. Everybody had worship, but then he was gone so long, and they came back down, and they had built the calf, the golden calves. They saw power. It wasn't enough to keep them chained. They were cool for a minute. Oh, that's great, but they built a golden calf. We have to be more. We have to be a people, and we are a people because our hearts have survived and been able to trust in our God. So we have the heart that has been made to be a heart that's entrusted with the power and authority that God would have us to walk with. So now is the hour for us to walk in authority as kingdom dwellers. It is time for us to take our rightful place and walk in authority that God has. And a lot of things, sometimes I have these conversations, and I was telling somebody that I want to be the type of person that when I see somebody struggling with something, I can call that thing up out of them. I don't want to be fighting a whole lot of time. I want to be able to know what it is to say, come out. And there's a difference. See, power, the kingdom of darkness has some power too. We can't go head to head, but it has to succumb to the authority that we walk in as kingdom, as those that represent the Most High God. And this is time. When Jonathan died, there are people that went to believe for resurrection for him. Some people went over to the funeral home, talking to the guy afterwards. He was like, I said, have you ever had anybody to come over here to pray for resurrection for somebody? He was like, well, ma'am, I'm going to tell you. No, in all my years of doing this, I have never heard of anything like this. And I said, well, let me tell you, I believe in a God that can resurrect. And let it not be that he not get up from this place because nobody took the time to come over here to speak breath, to speak life in him. Yes, we didn't have to go over there to do it because we do move by the Spirit. But did we do it? Did we even have a thought to do it? I had that conversation with a couple of people, and they're like, it don't take all of that. I'm like, if you were in that coffin, if you were laying there, what would you want? We got to stop being so, oh, God is not. Can't he not? Why can't he? He is God. Who can stop him? We can delay him by not doing what he asked us to do, but do we really believe that he is able? This is the hour. We say we want to change Birmingham. We say that this is the time for Birmingham to be changed. What are we doing to change it? Are we in here hollering, screaming, doing our thing, and afraid to go out? This time is demanding that we look different. We want to fight about, you know, Trump or Hillary. For real? People are dying. We have people that are in an identity crisis all day long. What is important? For us to demonstrate the love of Christ, for people to know that truly he can set you free and you can remain free. God is true. I do not think so many ways that I used to think because I allow the word of God to change my heart, to change my mind, to change my thinking. And it's time. I believe that the Lord is causing up warriors in this hour. I know that we are again. One of the things that he said was he talked about our hearts. When I asked him to forgive me for not understanding what he was speaking to me about, that he was like, "See, you don't really know who you are in this place, in this time. You have an idea, but you don't really know." And I was like, "Okay, Lord, help me." So just the other day, I was walking through, and I had the thought, "And David perceived he was king." And David perceived he was king. David perceived he was king a long time before David became king.
That's good.
If I'm not able to step into a place where God has said or who God said I am, if I don't perceive myself as being that thing based off who God said, I won't ever step into it. It is time for us to perceive ourselves as God has said we are. He has said it. He speaks to me in such a, just a funny way. Being in Florida a couple weeks ago, I shared this briefly. Fear, that was the week of the two murders or killings, and then the police officers being killed. And I was in Florida. I don't really know the space that I was in, but one night I had been worshiping. I felt like something was encroaching it, and it caused me to be fearful. And so I wanted to retreat. And I was like, "Well, wait a minute, what is this?" You know, I was in bed, pajamas the whole nine, but I felt like I wanted to retreat. And I'm like, "Okay, what do I do? What is this?" And I heard, "Get up and worship. No, go get your flags." And so I'm talking myself out of why I can go outside at close to midnight to get my flags. I don't know these people. People shooting people out in these streets, Jesus. What's it going to look like? You mean going outside to get my flags? I'm flag outside. You know, again, they don't know me. So I heard myself talking myself out of why I could not go get my well, I can't go get my flag. So I went in my daughter's room and I said, "Hey, little lady, I'm going to go outside. I'm just letting you know. Expect me in a few minutes. Come check on me." I don't know what she's going to do with her little 12-pound self. But yeah. So I went outside and I got my flag. So I'm going through my flags. I was going to get my lion one. It didn't feel right. So I picked up the flags that has fire and water and a heart in the middle of it. It's a latest set of flags that I have. As soon as I picked them up, I felt this lifting. And I looked up in the sky, because, I mean, like, it was like, I looked up in the sky. The sky was black, full of stars. The stars were so bright. And oh, my God, when I tell y'all, this sound came out, this movement came, and it was like just going in, just praying in the spirit, and the thing that had come was pushed back. And he said, "This is the people. This is what the people look like that I call to move in this hour looks like." And I was like, "Lord, that's what we look like." And so it's like, when you step into who I called you to be, that's exactly what you look like. This is the hour for you to shine. So he started talking to me like, "Greta, you carry power. You move in power. You are a woman of power. I've called you to be a woman of power and a woman of faith." And I'm like, "Well, Lord, I don't see it like that." And he said, "Look up again." Y'all, I felt strength. Come on. That, again, what can I do? What can't we do? We need to perceive differently.
Come on,
we have to. We're quirky. We are. Some of us move a little different than others. I know that, again, I can yell all day. What? I'm so glad everybody was loud tonight. I was like, "Yes, they screaming." But I think it's time for us to war.
Not everybody is warriors. I understand you don't get it. But there is a time, there is a place in the spirit right now for us to be able to advance. We are going to have to put on war. We are going to have to step into a place. The word of God says that God is a God of war. And again, we talk about this loving God. God is love, but there is a place where you have to fight back. You got to push back some things. And in this hour, it's time for us to stand up, stop being half-hearted about things, understand that freedom comes when we move the way that we are called to move, when we roar the way that we are called to roar, when we put on strength. We have won battles. Look at what you've been through. You're still standing, right? The battle has been won. God has put strength in you. He says the joy of the Lord is our strength. We are joyous people. Don't tell me we don't party. It is time. It is time. It's time for the warriors to run. It's time for the war. That's how we play. We play. We were made for this thing right now. I don't want to hear about another person dying of cancer that we have not tried to pull that thing up out of them. I don't want to hear about somebody else confused about who they are and what their gender is. I want to be able to look at a man and think he's a woman and say, come up out of there. You are called to walk. Stand straight, upright before the Lord, full of power and full of might. It is time. And again, see, I'm not cute. It's not time for that. It is, you are stuck. You can't be free. Let's do this thing and let's go do it for some other people. That's it. Get in a place of prayer. Yes, we have to worship. We can only fight after we come from worship. When we truly see who God is for us, what battle can't we win? He is really fighting it. We just walking it out. We want to fight anyway. Look at them folks, them Facebook posts. We want to fight anyway. Let's fight effectively. Let's fight effectively. Let's fight for real and change some lives and stop. And let's do it. I'm serious. We have to walk in the unity of Christ to be free who he called us to be. We are children of the Most High God. Can we look like it? Can we talk like it? Can we act like it? No, we don't have to quote the scripture, but we need to know it. It needs to become alive in us. He is the spirit of truth. Yes, the truth is what sets us free. Let's get the truth in us and let's move from that place. I think we want to just, you know, again, go out to people and give them a scripture. Be free. Come up out of there. Let's go. Yeah. Why we make it complicated? Why we make it complicated? Come on, girl. See, again, this is why I don't like to do this. We're supposed to be polished. I like intimate. You know, no, but we've been doing that too long. We come, we listen to a message, and we go out and we be bound. When I tell y'all I don't look the way I used to look, you better believe me. I know that God can change a person. I know what he can do in the life of somebody that believes. I know what it is when they tell me that my husband is not going to walk out of the hospital. And I tell them my husband is coming out of here because the Lord said that we are going to do something in ministry. And we have yet to do it. And when I tell you that that man walked out of there 8 days later, we had all kinds of people coming in that hospital room to say, what happened? This is not even possible. And then he got on the vest, y'all. I love him. 24 years. Why he got on the defibrillator vest? Going to the doctor, 20% heart rate, heart pump. He had advanced heart failure. 20% pump rate. He's not going to come out of here. He is going to come out of here. We on the way home. This brother want to go get some cigarettes. I said, that thing is coming out of him. So I got plenty practice. I have plenty practice. But I tell you what, my husband will tell you to this day, I felt my life change 3 times. I felt like it wasn't going to be here. But I heard you praying. I know that I'm alive because of your prayers. And don't give up. I'm like, how can I give up on you? I am you. I got your rear, bruh. I've been dealing with you for too long. God made me a promise. You think I dealt with you just because I love you like that? I love you. I love Jesus more, though. I love him. I'm trying to serve him. So I have to do what he called me to do when he says that You my husband. I said that. He knew I was going to sign up for it. But he knew that I loved him so much that I would do whatever he asked me to do and that I would trust him at his word. He introduced himself. The first thing I asked God. Now, he told me some things. But, but I asked the Lord if he would take the fear of getting married. I never wanted to get married. I never saw one that lasted. That was happy. His parents were married forever. But I never saw people that were happy and married. So I was cool, you know, just living together and everything. But I was. I thought I was. I was. But 3 weeks after I got married, I was driving down the street. And again, I don't know how I had these conversations with the Lord. I said, Lord, I just said my vows to you, and I don't know you. But I know that my marriage will not last unless you teach me how to love. Wow. Only God knew what it would mean. He knew that if he answered me, that I would serve him. And I have had to learn how to do this thing, sometimes feeling like by myself. Because I didn't know a lot of people that had lordship, that really lived a surrendered life and really heard the word and allowed God to meet them when they wanted to walk away, when they wanted to give up, when the battle was too tough. But he heard me and I heard him. And you guys have heard the Lord. Some of you have tried to walk away, but you were obedient to come back when he said, come back. You have stood when you wanted to give up. You have the heart of a warrior. You have won many a battle. We have won a fight right now because people are dying in our city. And it's time for us to do what we called to do in this hour. When I left the funeral home the other day, when I tell you I felt like I just wanted to, I wanted to kiss people. I wanted to stop everywhere and just say, God loves you. I was so full of faith. No, he didn't get up. But I know that my God was more than able to put breath back into him if that was what he chose to do. And there is something so rich and so deep about knowing and believing God like that. It's time for us to be a people of faith. Oh, my God. My husband was like, if you don't sit down, please. If you don't sit down, but all I could do was praise God and worship him and cry because he is so absolutely good. He is so absolutely good. And just think, Jonathan, he had a smile on his face. What is it to leave your body in faith? You know, so many people are so afraid out here. And we have the answer to it. We could speak to that fear. We need to stop walking in it ourselves. How are we lovers of Christ and knowing who he is for us? And we fearful of anything. You know, look, again, you do you, but I'm gonna tell you, I'm not carrying a gun. Unless God tell me to get a gun, I, again, want to have the kind of power where that bullet can come at me and I can say stop, and it stop, it fall to the ground. I want somebody to roll up on me acting crazy so I can say, Timothy, you better slow that down. Do you know that you called for greatness? And he just fall out crying or something. Come on. Who we want to be? What do we want to do? We want to still keep be cute and put the sentence together. I can speak, you know. Y'all see me do my job. You be like, is that Greta? That's me. But right now, we got to stop playing church. We need to be who he called us to be, free to be who he called us to be. I don't know if y'all got ever seen me this free again. But I think for me, this is something for myself, too, where I have to just say, you need to be willing to just be cool. We stop trying to be impressive. Impressing people for what? They dying.
you know, what are we trying to impress each other for? Let's just be free and who God called us to be, however he made us. If you loud, if you want to run, as long as it's from the voice of God and it's by the Spirit of the Lord, because we recognize too when it's foolishness, and we can call that out too. We can call that out too. But let's just not play anymore. Let's really be real about being kingdom-minded. Let's see people change. Let's change our city. Let's bring the fire, because we carry it. We firebrands in the earth. The Lord said, Greta, you will raise up firebrands. They don't play. We ain't got no time for playing. We trying to do some things. Y'all know I got to pray in the spirit, so we're going to pray. Oh, I took more than 10 minutes.
You good? Hold on. Hey, listen, because we're all about to pray. There's an activation on this word right now. How many of you want to be free tonight? Come on, listen. If you want to be free, get up out of your seat. Come on down to this altar, and we're about to get it in God right now. Come on, we're about to press in. We're about to go, and we're about to go Holy Ghost up in here and go after this thing.
Father God, I thank you that we are a people of power, that we walk in authority that comes from the Most High God. Father, show us how to walk in authority. Show us, Father, open our eyes to see the ailments of the people and the things that are troubling people, that we might be able to give a word, Father God, that will call them out. Father God, we just thank you that this is the hour for freedom for your people. We thank you that we are worshipers, that we are sold out lovers for you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that as we keep our eyes on you, we can do anything that you call us to do, Father God. If you tell us to do it, we are more than able to do it. We thank you that we are equipped for every good work in this hour, Father God. I thank you, Lord, that you would put the raw back into us, Father God, that it would not be about what man say it's supposed to look like, that it would not be this, that we would just unlearn all the junk that has kept people in bondage, and that we would be free to be whoever it is and to move however it is that you said that we should move. Let it not be, Father, anything false or anything man-made, but that we truly move by the Spirit of the living God. Lord, we thank you that we hear your voice. We thank you, Father, that we are people that have your heart, that we know who we are in you, Lord Jesus. I thank you that you shape us, that you speak to us, and that you say, this is who you are, and this is what I called you to in this hour. I thank you that we would pick it up, that we would walk in it, Father God. I thank you for freedom. I thank you that the warriors have been awakened in this hour, and that we would get on the wall where you would have us to fight. That we fight from a place of victory, but again, it can't be done if we don't do our part. Father, we say we love you. We surrender to you. We want to look like our daddy. We do look like our daddy. And sometimes our daddy looks like a god of war, and he brings it. So I say, pick up your weapon of warfare. If this worship, pick it up. If it's the sword of the spirit, when it is the sword, you pick it up. Father God, let us walk in wholeness. Let us walk in truth. Let us walk in love, Lord. You have put your love in us. You have marked us by your love, Lord. We have been marked by the Most High God. Hey! We will roar. We will advance. We will stand. We go forth today, Father God. We go forth. We love you. We love you, Lord. We are people that have your heart, Lord. We love you.
Come on. There's a grace tonight to shake the heavens. Come on. There's people here tonight. You say, listen, I want to be free, and I'm not free. I'm bound. I've given my life over to a lie. And if that's you tonight, we want to pray for you. We want to break bondage off of your heart tonight. There's people here tonight that want to be baptized. You want to be crucified with Christ. You want to be raised in newness of life. If that's you, just come on down right now. Come on. There's grace tonight to begin to shake the heavens. Come on. There's grace tonight to begin to shake the heavens.
Come on, don't just pray some casual prayer. Come on, don't expect your prayer to move God unless it moves you. Come on. Come on, we're moving things in the Spirit right now. Come on, I'm not talking about an internal prayer. It says with the mouth, confession is made. Come on, just begin to open up your mouth tonight. Come on, begin to decree. Begin to prophesy. Come on, begin to pray like your life depends on it. Come on, begin to pray like awakening depends on your prayer, because it does. All of Birmingham right now is looking to you, asking for help. Help us. Show us the way. Show us Jesus. Show us the Christ. Come on, all of this nation. Listen, I'm telling you, the answer is not in a political party. Come on, the answer is not in this candidate or that candidate. The answer is in the gospel of Jesus Christ. And it's time for the gospel with power to be manifest here on the earth. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on, come on. Listen, I'm telling you, you don't even know how to pray for what we're believing for. God does. Come on, He's about to do exceedingly, abundantly, above what you could ask or think, according to the power that's at work in you. Come on, begin to let the power out. Come on, begin to let loose right now. Come on, come on. Come on, we're moving from power to authority. Come on, He's about to put His weight in your words. Come on.
Place in the house of God and in our homes and in our city. We repent for leaving you uncovered.
We repent for putting all of the spiritual weight and the spiritual burden upon your shoulders. And I'm telling you, God is about to raise up not just triumphant men, not just triumphant women, but triumphant families. And I'm telling you, come on, his body is getting his voice back. And so whatever's God giving you guys, come on.
I raised him up and sealed him in heavenly places. God said he's also called you and raised you and put you in heavenly places. And God spoke to me, he said that I'm rising with healing in my wings. And I heard that he said to rise, shine, for the glory of the Lord has come upon you. And he's saying that as I'm rising with healing in my wings, you are rising with me. I sent Pastor Jason a message the other day. He was talking about Ezekiel 47. Talking about the water was rising up in the temple. And it kept on rising, it kept on rising, it kept on rising. And right now, the water, the Holy Spirit is rising in this place. And it couldn't stay in the temple, but the doors. And it began to flow out into the doors. And it began to heal the land. And it began to heal the city. And through our prayers right now, as we're praying, that there's healing going forth from the sanctuary. That as we continue to lift up our voices, the water is filling the sanctuary. The water is filling the streets. Drug dealers are being saved right now. Crack members are being saved right now. People are coming out of the crack homes right now. Marriages are being restored right now. People with HIV is being healed right now. HIV is drying up. AIDS is drying up in the body. There are people with limbs are being born, being broken again. There are people with blind eyes are being opened again. War in the spirit. War in the spirit right now. Break every chain. Break every curse.
Yes, 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 yes. someone wants to be healed here. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We rebuke you, devil. We rebuke you, devil. Get out of our families. Get out of our children. Get out of our families. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You have no authority over our families. You have no authority over our children. You have no authority over this country. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You are the God. You are the God of Israel. You are the God of Israel. You are the God of Abraham. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I declare victory. I declare victory. I declare victory. I declare victory. I declare success. I declare success in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes. 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 In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Holy Spirit.
There earlier that the whole earth is moaning and groaning for creation of the Son and daughter for the revealing. But right now there's a travailing in this place that's going on right now. I need some CC. Men, we don't understand this, but ladies, you understand how to push forth the baby. And Holy Spirit said that there's a travailing in this place until Christ be formed in the people tonight. Christ wants to be formed in us tonight. The image and the image and likeness of Christ wants to be formed in us. I need some ladies just to get in the birth position right now. I need men to just kneel down. We gotta birth some things. We gotta travail deep into your deep inside your spirit. Christ wants to just to come out of you. Just begin to travail and birth pains right now until Christ be formed in the people tonight. Christ said, I want to be formed in you. I want myself to be seen in you. But you've got to birth me tonight. You've got to push tonight. You got to cry out for me tonight. You got to go all out for me tonight. You got to want me more than you ever wanted me before. You got to want me more than you want to breathe. Christ says, I want to be formed in you tonight.
State into this nation. Father, we declare in the name of Jesus that a nation can be turned in a day. Father, we thank you. You hold the hearts of kings in your hand. And even this night as we pray and we hold your heart in our hand, God, you're turning the hearts of kings. You're turning the hearts of rulers, Father, but you're also turning the hearts of prodigals. You're turning the hearts of those who have left and not known how to get back to the house of God. And Father, I thank you right now that you're reaching out by love. You're reaching out in power, and you're beginning to draw the lost back home to you, God. God, I thank you that these are the days of greatest harvest. This is the days of birthing. This is the days where creation is groaning with birth pains that cannot be uttered. And we declare in the name of Jesus that this would be a birthing center, that this would be a birth canal, that this would be a place where the plans and the purposes and the promises of God would come forth with great power and great authority. We declare in the name of Jesus, cancer, your rule is done. We declare in the name of Jesus, poverty, your stronghold is broken. We declare in the name of Jesus, divorce and division is no longer on the radar in Jesus' name. Come on.
Sound. season. It's due season. It's time. It's time. It's time. You have carried that baby full term. It's full term. It's full term. It's full term. The baby is crowning. The kingdom is crowning.
Come on, Jerry. Come on.
The glory is crowning.
Come on.
We see the headship of Christ. We see the headship of the Father. We see the headship of the crown. The Father coming through. It's full term. It's full term. Don't stop. You grab somebody's hand. Grab somebody's hand.
Come on.
Breathe. Tell them to breathe. Tell them to breathe. Tell them to breathe.
Come on.
Now tell them to push. 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 Rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. Rivers of living water. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Birth that deliverance. Birth that deliverance. Birth that deliverance. Birth that deliverance. You gotta deliver that baby.
Come on, there's grace tonight to catch intercession. A travail of intercession. Come on, how many of you tonight say, I want to be pregnant with the things of God? Come on, listen, if you come on, I'm telling you, like Mary, he began to overshadow her, and he gave her a word that was bigger than her. It was bigger than what she thought. And I'm telling you, Holy Spirit is overshadowing this place. He's looking for spiritual wounds that he can place his seed in. Come on. Come on, come on, just say, here am I, God. Lord, birth it in me, God. God, I want it to start in me, Lord. Come on, come on, all the reasons why not are gone. We got one reason why, it's called Jesus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. He is our intercession. He is our warfare. He is our victory. He is our healer. He is our deliverer. Come on. Of just full on everything you've got, praying, decreeing, prophesying right now. Come on, with everything you got. Don't hold back. Don't keep your mouth shut. The word of faith is where it's near you. It's in your mouth and in your heart, and it wants out. Come on, just begin to open up your mouth and begin to prophesy. If you don't have anything to say, the Spirit does, I'll tell you that. Let Him begin to pray His prayer through you. Come on, each and every one here tonight. Come on, come up. Come on up. Come on up and grab the arm of somebody. There's something about coming together. Come on. Everybody grab the hand of somebody. Come on. One heart, one mind, one body. Come on. And we're just going to go after it right now. We're going to go after it in the Spirit right now. Come on. Come on. Grab a hand of somebody to your left or to your right. Come on. Come on. Everybody get somebody. Everybody get somebody. Everybody get somebody. Come on. Right now. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. We welcome you. Holy Spirit, we agree with your prayer tonight. Shondorabondorabakato. Shambaramandarabashaka. Kumbaramandarabashikerabasondo. Kumbaramandarabashakarabatata. Kumbaramandarabakata. Etananamashikerabondo. Come on. Kumbaramatekerabashikatata. Kumbaramando. 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 Come on, you're getting pregnant with promise tonight. Kumbaramando. Shandarabasanda. Come on, pray. Pray until the shift happens. Come on. Shobara daraba shaka. Karamandaraba shaka. Honarerebushikerebando. Komaramandaraba shaka. Hey! Komaramandaraba shike. Komoreterebandaraba shaka. Komaramandaraba kata. Bondarebedinibiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribiribirib your prayers. Come on. 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 Give me another minute. Come on. Come on. Come on. You got to pray. Come on. We're praying past the place of comfort. We're praying into the place of calling. Come on. We're stepping out of comfort. Come on. Come on. Come on. Give us another minute. Come on. Come on. Come on. You're tearing down the old and you're building the new. Come on. Come on, come on, every voice, every tongue, come on. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, let heaven hear your voice tonight.
What the hell?
Oh, come on, let heaven hear your cry tonight. Come on, let heaven hear your. Come on, you're unlocking doors tonight. Come on, you're unlocking doors tonight. Oh! Oh! Fire! 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 Come on, come on, this is what birthing looks like. Come on, come on, come on.
Walls are coming down.
Come on. Come on, come on.
Walls are coming down in the spirit. Walls are coming down in the spirit. Walls are coming down in the spirit.
Come on, come on, come on.
Release the
sound.
Release the sound. Release the sound. Release the sound. Release the sound.
Father, we thank you, Lord, for every prayer prayed in this place, not just tonight, but every night. I'm telling you, this is a place of prayer. It's a place of worship. It's a place of power. It's a place of authority. And I'm telling you, tonight, something got plugged in. There was something that has been unplugged, and it was like an extension cord that had come out of the socket. And I'm telling you right now, God is plugging things in that have become disconnected in your life. If you've lost that source of power, you've lost that place of prayer, God is giving you grace tonight to come back into that place of prayer, to where prayer would not be drudgery, it would not be burden, but it would be your delight and it would be your privilege. I mean, what a great privilege to be able to commune with the living God, and that he would not just hear our prayer, but he would wait on our prayer before he moves in the earth. I'm telling you, listen, the future of our nation is in our hands and it's in our prayers. The future of the world is in our hands and it's in our prayers. And I'm telling you, if we can begin to dream the dreams of God and give the prayers of God a voice, we'll begin to give the Lord the city of his dreams. Amen. Greta, come on up here and pray us out, girl. Come on. Come on. Shambarabando. Come on, listen, this is something.
What you would have for us in this hour, Father God. I thank you that you are faithful to complete the good work that you have begun in us, and that we are equipped for every good work. This is the work that you called us to. We will not turn our plow. We will go forward. We are victorious. We are triumphant. We are who you said we are.
Come on.
We release the roar and we say yes. We say yes again. We say yes with a pure heart. We say yes with fresh vision.
Yes.
We say yes to fresh oil.
Yes.
We say yes to fresh fire. Your fire.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Ho. Ho.
Come on.
Ho.
Release the roar. Come on.
Hey.
Come on. Give him your yes tonight.
Hey, we are a people full of strength. We thank you for authority, Father God, to go forward. We thank you that we are a people of power and of might, that we are filled with the Spirit of the living God. Thank you, Father. Thank you for peace. Thank you for justice. Thank you that is what we carry, Father God. We thank you that we are carriers of justice, that we release your voice, that we stand upright, that we are righteous in you, and everything that is not of you will fall in this hour, Father God. I thank you, Lord, that we will not even receive those things that will fall down as rejection, but that we will understand that that is a place for us to walk. Hallelujah. Thank you that you put strength on us today. Thank you that you put strength on us today, Father God. Even as we lay down tonight, Abba, we say we look to see your eyes. We look to see your eyes, Father. We rest in you. We rest in knowing to whom we belong. And we thank you, Father, that we cannot be snatched out of the enemy's hands. We thank you that you are a strong tower and a safe refuge. We thank you that that is who you have created us to be. Strong towers and safe refuge, Father, for your people. Hallelujah. We thank you. We love you. And we say, yes, we are willing to be raw when the time is needed.
Come on.
We thank you, Father, that you take us from roughness to diamonds.
Come on.
And that you set your diamonds into place. And we are a people that would be set in the place that you would have us to be, Father God. We thank you for a greater planting in this hour. We thank you that we stand upright before you. Lord, we thank you for your love. And we will move from that place in Jesus' name. Amen.
Come on, can we give him your yes tonight? Come on, listen, that's why he's looking for a yes. He's looking for a yes.
So, Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we give you our yes tonight. We give you our yes. So on the count of three, we're just going to release a shout of yes. And what you're doing, listen, he's not going to tell you everything you're saying yes to right now. But you're saying yes to him. Because there's things that he's asking us to be a part of that honestly would so stretch your heart and your mind right now that you would be hesitant to give him your yes. And so I want you to know, listen, when you give him your yes tonight, he's going to take you up on it. Amen? So on the count of three, we're going to say yes. And then if you have children in Children's Church, we kept them a little late tonight. You'll see the sign on the screen. You can make sure you go pick them up. But just can we end with this? Just on the count of three, we're going to release a shout of yes. Amen? One, two, three. Yes!
Footsteps of my King. I can hear his heartbeat beckoning. In my darkness, he has set me free. Now I hear the Spirit calling me. He's calling, wake up, child. It's your turn to shine. You are born. Such a time as this, he's calling, wake up, child. It's your turn to shine. You were born for such a time as this, for such a time as this. Such a time as this, he's calling, wake up, child. It's your turn to shine.
Show.
It's your turn to shine. You were born for such a time as this. He's calling, wake up, child. It's your turn to shine. You were born for such a time as this. Such a time as this.